It's the most wonderful time of the year, so the question is, why are so many people stressed out? Today, our UAB psychologist Dr. Josh Claypo is in studio now to help us keep the joy during the holidays. Sounds like we need a mental health check, don't we? When we say supposed to be the most wonderful time, already I hear unrealistic expectations.
I think that's my tip number one, is that this idea that that it's supposed to be perfect, even though we say we know, kind of underneath we have this feeling like it's supposed to be perfect, and we have this feeling like we're supposed to be happy the whole time. And what happens is we get stressed because that's a normal thing. And then we realize, oh my gosh, I'm stressed, I'm supposed to be happy. That makes us more stressed. And it's this vicious, vicious cycle that we get into. And it has to do with unrealistic expectations and frankly, not cutting ourselves slack about being okay with not being happy all the time. Angry, sad, nostalgic, frustrated. All those things happen during the holidays.
So what do we need to do to take that down a couple of notches?
Number one, give yourself that permission to have the range of emotions. That don't hold yourself to this expectation that as soon as I'm not happy, everything is going down. Because it's not going to happen. The second thing is, or third thing is, moderation. Mm-hmm. I know that we overextend so much, Sarah. We try to make every cookie, every card, go to every party. We try to do all those things. And the reality is that we can't. We're not capable of doing it. And when we do that, that's when we get stressed. And then really the last thing that I think is important is, because we're going to be stressed and because there's a lot of things going on, paying attention to your physical health. You got to get some sleep. You got to eat well. You got to get plenty of hydration. Those kinds of things. It's the whole idea of be realistic. Don't expect perfection. And don't push yourself to the very edge, because if you do, you're just going to be irritated and you're going to be no fun. You're going to be the Scrooge that you don't want to be.
That brings us back to that self-care. And I know you've already been talking about this earlier and last night, but so many people are rocked by what happened with Twitch.
Yeah.
The DJ who took his own life.
Yeah. So, you know, and everybody's saying the same thing. You never know what's going on in somebody's life. And that is true. The thing is, though, there often, not necessarily in the case of Twitch, I mean, we don't know, but often there are some signs. Mm-hmm. They're a little bit down. They're a little bit off. They're not quite being the same. And I always tell people, when in doubt, ask, how are you doing? How can you, can I do anything for you? Just be there for them. People always ask me, though, why do people commit suicide? Why do they take their own lives? And you have to understand that when a person's in that frame of mind, they see themselves usually as a burden. Mm-hmm. They see themselves in incredible pain, and that's why they do it. It's not because they want to. They feel like they have no other option.
So we remind folks to take care of yourself, get some help if you need it. All right.